Hey guys, Mark here. I hope you're all doing well. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you one of my favorite braided paracord dog leashes. This is the so-called herringbone style, which I've dubbed so because it uses multi-strand herringbone knots to decorate the leash. It is not terribly hard to do, but it does require some patience and attention to detail. Now, as far as supplies go, you're going to need two cords about 14.5 feet long, then two cords 2.5 feet long, as well as a snap hook so you can attach your leash to a collar. You're also going to need a lacing needle, a lighter, and some scissors. With these few supplies ready, we can begin our dog leash. So I have my snap hook here, and I'm going to take my two longer cords and feed the ends through, and then line them up so that all the ends are of equal length. We're now going to tie a multi-strand Matthew Walker knot. So line up your cords. And we're going to start with the first one on the left. And we're going to create a loop. Then go around all of the cords and into this loop. Then with the second cord, we're going to go through this loop. Then around all of the other cords and into the second loop. With our third cord, we're going to go through the first two loops, then around the other cord, and into the third loop, which we just made. And finally, with our last cord, we're going to go through the first three loops, and then into the loop we just made. Now, we need to slowly tighten our knot by pulling out the slack. Be very careful that you do this extremely slowly so that the knot will not distort its shape. So once you have your knot lined up and the slack pulled out, what we're going to do is take the bottom of the cord here and pull it towards the top. We're going to do that with the second cord as well. And then we're going to pull out the slack. Now you're going to notice that we have some slack between our snap hook and our multi-strand Matthew Walker knot, so we're going to pull that slack through the knot so we get a nice attachment for the snap hook. So like this. I'm now going to retighten the knot a bit more, and then we're going to continue with our 4-strand braid. So I've retightened my knot, then I'm going to attach my snap hook onto something, and we're going to split off our two sets of cords, one to the right, one to the left, and we're now going to do a 4-strand round braid. As you can see, this is a simple braid. All we're doing is alternating the top right and left cord and braiding our leash. We're going to braid all the way down until we have about 2 or 2.5 feet remaining in our ends, and this should be enough for a 3-foot leash. So I've braided up my ends and I have marked down where I have 3 feet in my leash. And the rest of the braid I'm going to turn up to create the loop for our handle. So like this. And I'm going to work in all of these ends into the braid. We have 4 ends and each of these ends is going to follow one of the cords in the braid. So I'm going to take this one and attach a lacing needle. And then follow one of the cords in the braid 3 times. So I'm going to enter the braid 3 times. This should be enough. We don't want to make this splice too long, just enough so we can secure our ends. So just pick out one of the cords and follow it with one of your ends. So I've entered the braid once. Twice. And now one more time. And I'm going to do this with all 4 of my cords. So this was the first one. Now let's pick out another cord. For example, this one. And I'm again going to follow one of the cords. So I've spliced in 2 of my cords, do the same with the other 2, and then we're going to continue by tying a multi-strand herringbone knot to cover this splice. So we've come to the hard part of our tutorial, and we're now going to tie a multi-strand herringbone knot. We're going to tie it over this spliced end to cover it. So take your bottom cords and place them over to the top. Then take all 4 of your cords and wrap them around your spliced end 2 times. So this is one wrap and the second wrap. This will create 8 cords to work with, and I have set up my working ends to the bottom on the right. We're going to start with our first cord from the left. Take a lacing needle, or you can just do it by hand, and we're going to go under, over, under, over, and under, over. So we're going to do 4 unders and 4 overs with our first cord. And we're going to do the same with the other 3. So we're now going to take the next cord from the left. And we're going to start with the byte that we just created here and go under it. Then go over, under. Over, under. Over, under. And over. So remember, we need 4 unders and 4 overs. Don't do more than that. Then we're going to take our next chord from the left. And we're going to enter the next byte, which we just created. So this one here. And again go under, over. Under, over. Under, over. And under, over. Again, 4 unders, 4 overs. And we only have one more chord remaining. So with our last one, we're going to again enter the next byte and do 4 unders and 4 overs. So here. And with this, we have tied a 9-part 4-byte multi-strand Turk's head knot. We're now going to interweave it into a herringbone knot. So to do that, we're first going to take one of the ends. We're going to start with the one we just used and go under your next working end. And then follow the standing end that's on the left of it. So this one. We're going to double up that standing end all the way to the right side. We've done one chord so far, and we're now going to do the next one. So search for the next one that you should do, which goes over 2. And then again, go under your next working end, and then follow the next standing end towards your right side. In my case, this would be this one. So we've done 2 chords so far, and we have 2 remaining. Again, find the chord that goes over 2 when it comes out, and this is our next chord. We're going to start by going under our next working end, and then follow the standing end towards your right side. We only have one more chord remaining, and we do the same thing. So we go over 2, then enter the knot going under our next working end, then follow our standing end towards the right side. And we're now going to do the interweave. So we've exited the knot with an over, so we're also going to enter with an over. So go over the first byte, and our next working end, that's over 2, then under 2, over 2, under 2, and so on until you reach your other end. Remember that each over and under splits a pair of parallel chords. And we have completed one of our chords. And let's do the next one. So again, over 2. So over the next byte and our next working end. Then under 2, over 2, under 2. Always splitting pairs. In the third chord, again the same thing. So over 2, under 2, over 2, all the way to the left side. And now with our last chord, the same procedure. So over 2, then under 2, over 2, under 2, and so on. Now, once you've done all four of your chords, all there's left to do is to retighten the knot and work in the ends towards your right side. This will create 4 more bites on the left side, which we need for a proper look for a herringbone knot. So simply work in your working ends to the right side. So I've retightened my knot and worked in my chords to the right side, where I can just snip them off. And to get the best look for this knot, it's best to roll it underfoot or between 2 pieces of wood, for example. We're also going to do a herringbone knot at the bottom, so we're going to use our 2.5-foot chords and work them in through the braid at the very start of our braid, basically creating a cross. So we have our chords lined up nicely around the braid. So like this. And make sure all of your chords are of equal length, so about 1.25 feet each. And we're now going to splice all of our ends into the braid, just like we did with our first knot. And this time we're going to splice it under 2 sections. So we're going to go in 2 times. So this is the first time we entered the braid. And I'm going to do it one more time. Do this with all four of your cords, and we're going to continue by tying another herringbone knot. So I've spliced in all of my cords, and we're going to tie a small herringbone knot. So wrap around your cords just once. So you have four cords to work with. And we're going to start with our first one from the bottom right. And go under, over, under, over. We're then going to take our second cord. And go under, over, under, and over. With our third cord, again, enter the next bite and go under, over, under, over. And with the last cord, enter the next bite and go under, over, under, over. We're now going to do the same thing with it with the previous knot. So we're going to go under the next working end and then double up a standing end. As you can see, this smaller knot is much easier and faster to work with. So our next working end, again, under the next working end, and double up a standing end. And the third cord. Remember that we're going over two when we exit, and then we go under the working end, and then towards the right side, doubling up a standing end. And then again under our next working end, and then double up your last standing end. And now we're going to do the herringbone, which starts by going over two, then under two, over two and under two. Basically again splitting pairs of parallel cords. And the next cord, again starting with an over. We start over two because we also exit the knot with an over. So over two, under two, over two and under two. Then the third cord. Over two, under two, over two, and under two. And the last cord, over two, under two, then over two and under two. And now we have all of our ends on the left side, and we're again going to feed these ends under the knot towards the right side. So with our working hand, for example, I'm going to go under towards the right. And then do that with all four of the chords. Then tighten up and roll the knot. I just want to show you how you finish the ends after you've cut them. And you basically just feed them into the knot. This will secure them and hide them out of vision. So guys, I hope that this tutorial wasn't too hard, and I would like to congratulate you for coming this far. Thank you for joining me in this tutorial, and see you next time.